The shooter does from behind the net.
Go. Walk from behind. Okay. Our concept here is we're going to play our sharp angles a lot more aggressively. All right? No more sitting and waiting on the post. We're going to take it away. All right? We're all going to be fast enough to do so. All right? So here's what we're going to do. As soon as we take the puck, he's going to come around the net here. All right? He's coming out between these two corners. That's exactly what I want you to see me, what I want to see you do. I didn't even have to tell Caleb. He just went right there. Alright? That's exactly where I want to see how spread he is. Like literally, if I'm gonna be here now, I gotta go under the bar, short side, and then an angle. And if you take another little step out, I'm not gonna be able to do it, right? As I move up. See how short, little subtle footsteps he takes? He doesn't make big drastic shuffles. He makes shuffles that mimic the speed of the shooter. All right? If you move faster than the speed of the shooter, if you don't match his speed in a horizontal situation, it's just as dangerous as a vertical situation. Understand what I'm saying? If a shooter's going right down on a breakaway, and you don't back up fast enough, well, he's just gonna go right around you. Not much different on a situation like this. If a guy's beating you with speed going horizontally, he's gonna open you up. All right? That's the whole idea. So, what we wanna do here is make sure we're getting out off that post with a quick adjustment as soon as he's around that pylon, and we do exactly what Caleb just did. Mimic the speed with short little bursts. Shooter is going to shoot from between these two pylons, right? One on this side, and go back and come back on the other side, all right? So that's what we're going to do, all right? Right there. Shooters, over there. What we're going to get into right there is our post coverage, rebound creation, and reaction. Meaning that you're going to be down, actually, we're going to do that right there. Because you're going to do it on the right side and then the left side of the net. All right? That is as simple as this. How come? Simulated play, you're in your post coverage. You're going to go from the VH and VH reverse. Alternate both methods of post coverage because you should be able to do both methods of post coverage. Right? Watch NHL goalies. They can do both methods of post coverage. They're both are situational and good in different situations. Alright? So on those nets there, we're going to do one on the right and one on the left. We're going to either sit in the DH reverse, what Caleb's doing here, and there's going to be another shooter off here, alright, who is essentially a rebound hunter. That is his whole job. But what's the biggest threat?
Right there.
Well, the hardest thing to control is a puck off the side. Where's it go? Right in the slot. Right? So what we need to be able to do is we need to be able to react and respond appropriately. Right? So that's why we're doing this from each side. So you're going to have your VH and your VH reverse from each side there. Down in the far end. Four puck, high bottom adjustment, bobbing, yep. The reason we're going to get high, the main tension is still here, four pylon, one pylon. Cup 3. This final.
Thank you. So go one puck and the next puck, right?